So today we are going to talk about unsupervised classification using Saga. Now, we will create a land use and land cover map of a region by the unsupervised classification method using Saga. And the precursor or prerequisite of this tutorial or video is that you might have completed or you should have completed the previous videos. So to create a land use and land cover map of an area, we have to assign corresponding land use and land cover type to every pixel in the satellite imagery that exists in the type of at the time of acquisition. Meanwhile, let me open Saga for you. So this is done based on the digital number value of the pixel, which in turn represent the spectral properties of the ground surface. This assigning of classes to pixel in an image is called as image classification. And more specifically or technically, it is an aspect of image processing in which quantitative decisions are made on the basis of the data present in the image, grouping pixels or regions of image into classes representing different ground cover types. And this output of the classification stage may be regarded as thematic map rather than the image. There are two broad types of image classification, supervised and unsupervised. We are going to look at unsupervised today. In this unsupervised classification, the algorithm analyzes all the bands of the image and pick out the clusters of pixels having similar values without the user intervention. And the clusters are then assigned to their classes at the user's discretion. Therefore, this method generally applied to the region where we don't know or we don't have any knowledge and information about the land cover type. So we'll use 7-band Landsat thematic mapper image to create a land cover map of Pune and its surrounding region. And this imagery can be downloaded from USGS Earth Explorer. Let me open a new project and I'll show you from where to get the data. This is the dstiget.in website. Download PDF, download data for unsupervised classification for this particular tutorial. Now, as we have done already downloaded this content, let me show you this 7th data, what we are going to use today. This is subset landsat.tiff. So let me copy the link and open it. So how to start? First is Landsat thematic band. The wavelength vary from 0.45 to 2.35, right from blue to our mid-infrared. So all regime is there, all coverage is there in various bands. So we'll be using this RGB composite. Let's just open it. Say all files, just open it. It will ask for band because we have 7 bands. As I can show you, there are 7 bands. These are the ranges of this band. So these are the ranges of the band. Band 1 to band 7. So I'm opening this all bands. Okay. Say okay, these bands have come up. Once this is done, let us see that how we can make RGB composite. And you know how to make RGB composite. We'll make 2 RGB composite. First is our true color and then we'll make a FCC, a false color composite. For true color, you know and you are aware that we use combination 3-2-1, and for this 4-5-2, we'll use 4-5-2 for our the second one, that is our FCC. So how you are going to make it? Just go to find and run tool, find RGB composite. So this is RGB composite. Make it like this. Grid system is this one because only one grid system is there. For this, we assign band 3 for red. Red for band 3, then green 2 and blue this one. And don't forget to keep this as create. If you don't make it create, it will override the previous version, right? So you have to make sure that this has to be create. Okay, so let us make it okay. And once I press okay, this composite has come. So the composite has been made. Let me open it for you. This is a composite. If you want to rename it, let it be say true color, or make it say 3-2-1 composite. So let us go to this one and make it 3-2-1 composite. 3-2-1 tab, apply. So name has been changed. Let us make one more composite. Make it as 4-5-2. So now this will be 4, this will be 5, and this will be 2. 4-5-2. And then again, if you this is 3-2-1 composite and you create it, because if you don't do it, this will be created on or will be overwritten on this 3-2-1 composite, but we want a new one. So let us make it okay. This is again a composite. Let me open it for you. This is FCC. Okay, make it 4-5-2 composite. 4-5-2 composite. Okay, press tab and press apply. Now the name has been changed. These two are there. Now come to this composite means map. There are two composites, 452 composite and 321 composite, right? Now in this map, as you see, you can show, let me show you vertically. And if I want to show it, what I can do, I can go here and say, there are various options. I can show it, show layer, I can show, and I can easily, there are two options, show and unshow. So these two you can do. Now you might be surprised that I'm now trying to teach this super unsupervised classification, but I'm making composite. Why I'm showing you this show layer and unshow layer? This is because once we'll make that supervised stuff, how we are going to see that on the background of it, which features are there? For that, I'm showing you. Once I will show all these three on one. Let me take it here. Okay, now we have only one composite, and these two are one over another. So let me unshow it. See, if I unshow it, there is only one image, and let me show it. So it has come on it. So our the third one, that is the classification image, will come on it this only. So how we are going to make a classification image? For that, you have to go to cluster analysis for grids. In this PDF, it is given this cluster analysis for grid. But I hope that in this version you will not get it. In this version about Saga, this version you will not get it. For that, you have to go to this tools. Go to you can go to grid analysis and try to find out some cluster analysis for grid. And if you are not able to find out, let me go to some other place. Say, because this is actually an analysis. We'll go to imagery and classification. In this imagery, we'll go to classification, and this k-means clustering for grids. This is okay. K-mean clustering grid system. You choose this one, which is only one grid system. And now in these grids, what you're going to choose? This is important. In these grids, once you go and once you are on this dialog, you choose all these seven. Don't choose this 8 and 9, which we have just made. Choose this and say okay. Now I want to do clustering for all this. Clusters create, you will create a cluster, otherwise it will be overwritten, so we'll create it. For statistics, let it be created. There are three methods: iterative, minimum distance, hill climbing, and combined minimum distance or hill climbing. So these three methods, this hill climbing, which we are going to use, this hill climbing algorithm is an iterative local search partitioning algorithm. It is designed to search for optimum value of clustering criteria by rearranging existing portions and keeping the new one only if it provides improvement. Then this iterative, or this one iterative, this is iterative minimum distance algorithm, which searches for clusters whose seed centroids are initially randomly distributed. It divides the pixel population according to the nearest cluster seed. Each cluster is characterized by the mean distance of its point to the seed, and this algorithm then adjusts the position of the seed to decrease the mean distance. Then finally, this combined minimum distance, this serves a combination of the earlier two. So make hill climbing. How many clusters do you want? Initially, you make 50 clusters, but because this is an example scenario, so I'll make say only 10 clusters. You have to make at least 50, then we will combine it. Maximum iteration, it depends on you how many iterations you want, but I'll tell you where we have to stop. And don't press this or tick this checkbox, otherwise your computation will really take a lot of time, right? So let it be like this. Maximum iteration will not give. Say okay. See this progress bar. This clustering has started. This is k-means clustering. And here these passes are changing. See, pass 8, pass 9. And the time it reaches the 0 version, means it reaches to 0 value, we'll stop it. It reaches up to say 50, 60. And we'll wait for it. Don't worry. This has reached, see this has reached 0.00. And we'll wait for it to reach 0.00. So see, it has reached. And we'll wait, don't worry, because as these value reaches to 0, then we'll have the best clustering. K means give the best clustering, because change should be 0. So let it go. So these numbers are found, and please mark that this is becoming 0. And as this is becoming 0, this pass will eventually, we are going to stop this pass, right? So it has already stopped by itself. Otherwise you need to stop. You can stop it just by going to geoprocessing, and this K means clustering for grids. This will be checked. You uncheck it. Because our clustering has already stopped just because it has reached zero. So we don't have to stop it, but you have to stop it because you will be making 50 clusters. Now what we achieved by this? We go to maps, this tree, and we see that we have clusters, right? This has come. Let me click it for you and open. So now this is what we wanted. These are the clusters, different clusters. We have 10 clusters. So go to this map and again transfer this cluster to here, right? And try to put it on the top. Now, if I don't show this cluster, this is not shown. If I just show the cluster, I say this is shown. So these three are layers one over the another, one over another. That is why I wanted you to make this 3, 2, 1, and 4, 5, 2 in different combination, and then this cluster will be shown here. Okay. So we'll assign some value, unique numbers to each of these land covers, and we'll use this simple 6-class classification, which you can find it from here. These are the 6 classification. These are the classifications, right? Built up 1, agriculture 2, scrub 3, open scrub barren 4, water 5, and forest 6. So these are the classification which we are eventually going to find out. So the next is actually going to our cluster. Let us go to the cluster. And now this cluster is there. Go to the attributes, legend, and then this legend will show 10 clusters. Okay. When you go to this legend, you'll see that 7 clusters are there. Now, how will you find out which cluster this pixel belong or the classification value belong? You hover it and you see that, observe this cluster value, Z value. When I hover it, it shows me that on which cluster or in which cluster this pixel is assigned to. Okay. So this is quite easy. Now we will start assigning class numbers of these class numbers to the cluster by selecting the layer and then accessing this setting tab. This setting tab. How we are going to do it? For that, let me go to this. And here, lookup table. We under this lookup table, okay, we have a lookup table, and let me open this lookup table. So this is a lookup table right now. Okay, so let me save this lookup table. And I'll go to the path, this path. Let me save this lookup table for you because we would eventually need it at one point. So let me go to that path and say lookup table LT, that will be LT. Save. So this we have just saved. And if you want to see that this LT.txt has come or not, you will open it in Microsoft Excel. So I'll open Excel also. Excel. Microsoft Excel. And we'll see what has come, because I have initially, after I have got this table, I want to save it because I am going to use it somewhere. So I saved it and I want to see what I have saved it. So I will open this what we have saved just now, just to show you that how we can get or whether it was correct or not. Otherwise we'll make another one. So this is star lt.txt. Open it. And once I open it, make it next, finish. See, color, name, description, and minimum maximum has come. Right? This has come. What you can do is, there are two methods. One is given in this PDF. The other is, I can share it with you. What you can do is, you can change the name here. You can change the name here itself and description here itself. And you can just go to Saga and load. Again, load this file. You can load this file back to this table. You can just load it. As I saved it, in the similar fashion, you can save. The save material can be loaded also. So this you can do. But here they have given a different aspect. So let me tell you that there are some minimum and maximum values. What they have given in this content, because you'll be following this content, they have given value should be 0. Let me make it 1. Make it 1. In the text they have given, okay, apply. Now, are you able to see this? Are you able to see this yellow patches? Right? Yellow patches. Now, this is what we wanted. In the content, actually, it was given that you assign values as 0. But you please don't do this. Make it as 1. Otherwise, you will not be able to see it. You will be troubled like what I showed you that you'll be troubled that the content, these pixels will not be shown. So I'll go back again and I'll mark it minus 1. I'll mark it minus 1. Okay. And okay. Apply. So I'll be shown only those, this will be yellow, only those which corresponds to my first cluster, my first cluster. And as you see, this is, let me unshow it. This is plant. This is actually water. This is water. Or water bodies. So now we have got our first one, first class. And what is that? The first class is our, this one, let me show you. We have made a table of that. What is this? This is water. So we'll assign 5 here. We'll assign 5 here. Name, assign 5. Right? And you will do it for all these clusters. You will do it for all these clusters. I hope you understand. I will not do it for every cluster. So let me just assign some values here. 3. I'm just randomly assigning it. 1 to 6. This is not correct. This is not correct. I'm just randomly assigning it. 7 is not there. Only 6 is there. 2, say 5, say 7. Okay. And press OK. So what you have to do is, now this table has been formed. Okay. What next step is there? The next step is, you have to save this table. How you are going to save it? You have to repeat this. I'm again saying that these are not correct. I've showed you one example and you have to do it for each and every cluster. I'm just saying that you have to make yourself arrangement by yourself, just by the method I've shown. Let me save this as I showed you. Let it be some, you know, LT1. Okay. LT1. Okay. Save. So now we have LT1. This was LT. Let me open again this LT1 now. Previously, what was LT? It was actual version, which we, if I need it sometime, I can get it back. But this LT1 is the recent one. Next, finish. But I need this minimum and maximum values, right? I need this minimum and maximum values. So what I'm going to do is, I'll go to the previous one, LT. I will copy these. Say, I'll copy all of these. Control C, and I will go to the latest one, which is minus 1. I'll paste it here. So then I can get the back value. Those values which were actually the values. And these are up to you. These are totally up to you how you do it. Right? This is my method of doing it. So these are minimum, maximum. And what I am going to do is, let me save it. Just for just now. Because I am going to change it. And let me delete also this. Delete this one and this one. This column, I don't require it actually. And this column, delete. This I will retain. This I am going to retain. Right, minimum we have, maximum and this name. But I know that this name is actually name. So I want to change it to number. I will change it to number. 5, 5, 3, 4, 2, right? We'll do it later. First of all, I'll show you how to change these grid values. How to change these grid values. You know, you have to go to click here. This way. So what we have to do is, you have to find out change grid values. Go to change grid values. Why I'm doing this? Because I'll be assigning change grid. So we have change grid values. We'll set this to this. And here we will replace this column. Okay. We'll again, we have this 10 clusters. Change grid is create. We'll create a new grid and replace condition. And here we are going to choose some values. Low value, high value, change with, replace with this. So for that, what you have to do is, again go back, what I was trying to suggest. This is minimum, this is maximum. Not this one, the other one. This is the other one, this is the recent one. So this is, what was that? Let me make a new one. Let me name it as new. And I will copy, make it as numeric first. Number. And what I will do is, I will copy all these, control C, to this. Okay? And I will delete this. Right? Minimum, maximum, new. See, we want what? We want low value, high value, and replace with. This is what we wanted. So we have created our lookup table such that we can have a value of this. This is lt1.txt. Right? So we have made a transition, making it, let us save it. This lt1, save it. Yes, I'll keep the format, no problem. Let me close it also. Yes, this I may not require. Now I'll go back here. I will load. What load? What I'm going to load? I am going to load this lt1 which we have just made. lt1. Let me go to that path. lt1. See? Now the low value and high value will be replaced by the new values. Will be replaced by the new values which we have just made in the lookup table in Microsoft Excel. So let me say it okay. And okay. And apply. Right? When I applied it, I will go back to our data and see this change grid has come. So what I have to do is, I have to go back and I have to keep it, this change grid, to, because this is actually what we wanted, this change grid. So we'll go to the lookup table by these lookup tables. We can easily open it. And now this is our actual classification. And you can easily transfer it here. And now you can easily see that this change grid, I want to show it, show layer. I don't want to show it. Now I want to show this. And if I don't show it, let me show this layer. Okay, let me show this layer. And now this classification, this change grid has come, which is actually over our previous images. So if I show it, it will be on the previous image. So this is the best idea. This is the best idea how you change the grid. Okay. So this is our final classified or unsupervisedly classified image which we intended. Now the important aspect here is this conversion. You don't require this actually. You know, in this PDF it has been given that you have to go to some Excel, you need to change. But once you are well versed with Saga and how to work with, you know, first time you have to do what I have taught. But once you are well versed with this unsupervised classification, I don't think you require this Excel. You can do it everything there itself, right? So I hope you know, this was quite complicated, but still you understood it. Once again, you can go back and you know, revise it. So this was unsupervised classification for you. Thank you so much. Take care.